Begin to the online broadcast network, AfterBuzz TV. Over 20 million weekly downloads in over 150 countries and your number one source for after-show entertainment. AfterBuzz TV, the destination for TV superfans. Producing aftershows for over 300 of your favorite TV shows. Interviewing celebrities and showrunners. And bringing you behind-the-scenes exclusives. All thanks to E! Entertainment's Maria Menounos, producer Kevin Undergaro, and internet leader Akamai. Now, let the buzz begin!
Welcome, AfterBuzzers, to another episode of AfterBuzz TV Spotlight On. If you haven't done so already, subscribe to our YouTube channel and make sure to check us up on iTunes and SoundCloud. And if you're tweeting along, use the hashtag Spotlight On. We've got a good one today. Multi-platinum artist, singer, winner of Sweden's Got Talent, future superstar Zara Larsson.
Yay.
Thanks for coming in.
Thanks for having me.
Are you exhausted? You've been so busy.
No, I'm not.
You're good?
I'm having a lot of fun. Yeah.
It's kind of exciting, right?
It's really exciting.
Okay, we're going to get to know you a little bit more.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just going to ask you a bunch of random questions.
Sure.
You got to say the first thing that pops in your head.
Okay.
You ready?
Yeah.
Okay. Song you wish you'd written.
Oh my gosh. It's a new one every day.
New one. What's the one today?
Today is Earned It.
Earned It?
The Weeknd, yeah.
Oh, that's a good one.
It's a really good one, yeah.
Favorite app?
But Instagram, definitely.
Instagram.
Oh, yeah.
We're going to be talking about Instagram later. Favorite member of One Direction?
I actually went to their concert in Sweden.
Oh, you did?
Oh, yeah. And it was cool.
They're really hot, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. I was standing next to like an 8-year-old girl, and we were screaming equally as loud.
Yeah.
And Harry tweeted the link to your video, too, right?
Yeah, he did. He did.
That's kind of exciting.
It was really a shock. Like, I'm super high to wake up in the morning. So my mom was, like, walking into my room, and she was like, some hairy dude tweeted you. And I was like, from One Direction? Like, I was awake like that.
That hairy would get me out of bed, too. Okay, three things you can't live without.
It would probably be... Is it boring if I say my phone?
No.
Okay,
I don't think anyone can. It's just normal.
My phone, not because I think more like my music that I have in my phone.
Okay.
Yeah. So the music that I have in my phone.
Okay.
And then it'll be,
Pressure is on.
Pressure is so
on. We can move on. We can live with the music in your phone. That's good enough.
Yeah, and that's pretty much it. Like,
times
I'm
three.
Very, yeah.
Okay, what was the last lie you told?
So many. No.
So many.
But the last lie, wow, I'm a really, really bad liar.
Oh, really?
Yeah, like, I can't lie.
Oh, I can lie on the spot.
No, I can't because it makes me feel so guilty.
No, like, can you tell like a white lie, or you can't tell any kind of lie?
Not even a white lie.
Wow, that's a good quality to have, or
really,
maybe bad. I don't know.
Sometimes, but I'm just a really bad liar.
Okay.
Like, people can really tell.
That's funny. Yeah. Okay, what's one thing that they have in Sweden that you miss in the U.S.?
Oh, I think you do have it. I can't find it. Black salty licorice.
You like that?
I love it.
Oh, I hate it. I don't even like the smell of it.
Oh my! Are you kidding me?
No.
Best.
I don't know if I've ever tried it salted, but I've tried.
You have to have it salted.
Like sea salt, or is it just? It doesn't
no, it's
matter.
Like it's a. I think it's a mix of like salt, and the. I don't. It's not like salt.
Oh.
But it's salty.
Okay, I'll try
and
it.
And it's a
I'll
little
give it
sour.
One try.
It's a little salt. It's. Very
good. Really, yeah. Very good. What is your favorite emoji?
I would say that it's a. It looks like this.
Oh, yep, I know. I know what you're talking about. And favorite TV show to binge watch?
Favorite TV show?
Yeah, that you can watch over and over.
Wow, probably Orange is the New Black.
Oh, that's a good
Game
one.
Game of Thrones.
Would you want your music on any of those?
Oh, yeah.
You're all about that?
It will be a little off on Game of Thrones,
yeah.
I guess. But
I guess a little. You like singing pop music.
Yeah, but I love... Game of Thrones and Orange is the New
Black. Those are good ones.
Yeah.
Okay, let's talk about music.
Sure.
So did you grow up singing?
Oh, yeah.
When did you first kind of get the singing bug?
I've always had it.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Since I was very little, like, I can't remember when it started because I've always wanted to perform in front of people and after every dinner I had with my family and like in front of my friends and every opportunity that I could stand in front of people and sing for them in school.
Yeah.
Like all the time since I was a little kid, like super, super little. I've always wanted to perform in front of people and to sing.
Is your family musical?
No.
Oh, they're not at all. You're the only one.
No.
No family bands?
I mean, my sister is, she's great. But my mom and dad is like, nah.
We don't know where it came from.
Nah, my dad played bass.
Okay.
In a punk band when he was 15.
But that's it?
That's it. And you don't have, I mean, you can know like two chords in a punk band.
Especially if you're playing bass. No offense, bass players, but yeah. I don't think it's that hard.
Yeah, but he was kind of good, I guess. But
ish. Yeah. So you tried out for Sweden's Got Talent.
Yeah.
What's the name of it there?
Talang.
Talang?
Mm-hmm.
Is that good?
Yeah, you said it perfectly.
Do most Americans mess that up? I feel like we're pretty dumb.
No, I think it's a pretty easy word.
Oh, I don't know. Talang?
I mean, I think it's easy. You say it perfectly.
Okay, thank you. Phew. So you won.
Yes, I did.
What was that like when you were 10 years old?
Wow, it's such a long time ago. It's 7 years ago.
Like, oh my God.
I can't believe it, but it's a really long time ago. And of course, it was kind of overwhelming, I guess, because sometimes today I think about, wow, whoa, I won it, you know?
Yeah, that's huge.
Yeah, and I was only 10, and I just tried out. I just did the audition, and I did it because it was a fun thing. I didn't. Of course, I wanted to win.
Uh-huh.
I won't lie, but
well,
yeah. But I just did it because I thought it would be fun.
Okay, we have a clip of you singing some Celine Dion on the show. We're gonna listen to that for a little bit.
I was so glad.
It's so cute. That's like singing though. When you're 10, like you can't hit those notes.
Oh God, I was so little.
Is it weird to watch that back?
Yeah, I never watch myself ever. So, yeah, it's pretty weird. Like that's me.
Yeah, that's. Look at you now. Do you watch like Idol or The Voice or X Factor or any of those shows?
Yeah, I do. Back and forth.
Okay.
Sometimes I don't. I follow it, but I don't watch
every
single episode. Yeah, but I watch it.
What's your advice? Because obviously you're a winner for somebody who's trying out for those shows.
Oh wow! I mean, it's the same concept for every TV show, even like for X Factor, American Idol, America's Got Talent. It's basically the same thing, and I just think that you should just do your own thing, I guess. Like, it's so cliche.
Yeah.
But
it's okay, we'll take it. I think the shows are cliche too, so it works.
Yeah, but I mean, it's hard because sometimes it's like the winners that won everything, it's like,
wee. Yeah, they don't have anything.
You know, yeah. And the girl or the guy who came third place or fifth, whatever.
Yeah.
You never know.
Fifth Harmony, they never won.
Yeah, exactly. So, and you never know because it's like, even if you win, I was very lucky. Like people actually kept on buying my music when I released my EP. But sometimes it's like, you know, even if you win, it's not, that doesn't automatically give you an opportunity to actually be a real artist outside of the show. You know what I mean?
And is it hard because you came out of that when you were 10 years old to kind of like be like, this is the music I want to make. And then as you grow up, did you ever feel like you were pigeonholed?
I mean, after the talent show, I just went back to school.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
When did you actually start recording stuff?
When I was 13-ish.
Okay.
So, because I was so small.
Yeah.
Like, what can you really do with a 10-year-old?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, and I, of course, I wanted to get a record deal, and I was like, hello.
I want to sing.
Yeah. But no one wanted to sign me. But then they signed me, the label or the record company I'm with now, 10. And then I signed with Epic Records on Sony in America. And like, so when I was 14-ish, it became pretty serious. That's what, yeah.
So you've been working on your EP, is out now.
Yeah.
So the song Uncovered, you've released that. It's gone platinum in Sweden a couple times. Mm-hmm. Is it, how's the song changed? Because I know the original was a little different than what we have now.
I mean, the original, the demo was kind of like Halo. It had drums.
And a lot of drums. Like, okay.
Yeah. So we just took that out, I guess.
Cause it made it more, a little more you?
Yeah, I wouldn't say that, but like we kind of compromised.
Okay.
Because I really wanted to release the song, but everyone was like, no, we don't know, you know, we don't know. But I was like, yeah, let's just do it. And then we stripped it down and it became such a beautiful song. So we were like, let's keep it like this and release it as a very, you know, it's a ballad.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's what we did, and people seem to love it, but no one have actually heard
the demo. Okay.
So what's out is what's been the always same. Been out.
Oh, okay. Is it hard? Because you've been singing it for like almost a couple of years now, too.
Yeah.
Now it's but, like your new single here.
Yeah, I mean, I guess that people think that I'm tired of it.
Yeah.
But I'm actually not. Like I've sang it a couple of times, but. It's really cool. I'm not tired of it, and I think it's because it's a really great song, and not only, I mean, it would suck if I was releasing a single that I kind of liked, and then it became a massive hit, so I was, you know, forced to sing it over and over again. But I really love this song, so it's cool.
That's good. We have a clip of it that we're gonna play from the music video.
Nobody sees. Nobody knows. We are a secret, can't be exposed. That's how it is, that's how it goes. Far from the
so,
others,
this is also the name of the cover. And it's all about love.
In the daylight,
it is. Was that intentional? All about love?
It's all about love. No, it wasn't. I just
late night,
I mean,
late night, when the moon is blinded.
I think it's very
plain sight.
Yeah, everyone goes through it.
Of course, yeah. And even though it's all about love, it's about love from different perspectives.
Is it like personal experiences, or is it just kind of like general concept?
I mean, I could definitely relate to a lot of the songs, or a lot. It's an EP, so it's six songs. But sure. I mean, even though I haven't been through like being with someone that I can't express my love to. Officially, I can still like kind of relate to it because
have you ever been in love?
Of course. Yes.
Like the real hardcore love.
Oh yeah, the real hardcore love.
Oh good. And you're in the studio right now with Afrojack working on new stuff.
Yeah, we were in the studio yesterday and the day before that. It was great fun. He's awesome.
What's the is it the same kind of vibe we're going with?
I mean, yes and no. It's I guess that if I won't change my music dramatically.
Yeah.
So if you like the EP, then hopefully you like the album.
The album.
Yeah.
I hear like a little bit of like Rihanna sass in you.
Yeah, I get that a lot. I actually don't. Well, I do. I think she's amazing. I have a lot of her songs on my playlist, but the only person I idolize is Beyonce.
Oh, that's I think that's everybody's idol, isn't it?
Of course.
And you've covered Halo a couple times.
Yeah.
That's good. Is there any Beyonce song that's like off limits to cover?
What do you mean?
Like you're afraid to take it?
Oh, I want to say that.
Yeah. Okay, good. You're like, So are you going to tour the album? Are you going to go out on tour with the album?
We'll see. Hopefully. Yeah, I would love to do a summer tour or to be the opening act for a bigger artist or on, you know, the radio.
Yeah.
They're doing, like, their summer tours. And so we'll see, hopefully.
So besides Beyonce, who would be your dream tour?
No one.
No one? Just you? Or just Beyonce?
No, but I guess that I don't really know. Like, I listen to a lot of music and a lot of artists. So it's not that I only listen to Beyonce, but she's the only person I actually look up to and want to be.
Okay.
If you know what I mean.
Yeah, that's good. Okay, we got to talk about, you've been getting in some trouble on Instagram.
Oh, no, I want to say
not
trouble.
Not trouble? Okay. So I'm going to bring up the caption. You posted this photo with a condom on your foot.
I did.
Tell me about why you posted it, and then we'll read the caption.
I mean, I posted it because I thought it would be a fun thing. I was so bored. I was home alone, and I put it on my foot, and then I was like, wow, it's really stretchy. So I rolled it up all the way to my knee, and then I just looked.
And it didn't break.
No, and I just looked at my leg, and I was like, I was thinking about all my girlfriends having, even their boyfriends, telling them that I can't wear a condom because I'm too big, it's gonna break. And I was just looking at my leg, and I was like, you guys are lying.
I don't think so.
Yeah.
So the caption says, to all the guys saying my dick is too big for condoms, take a seat.
Yeah.
So we're just gonna test this out.
Okay.
I have condoms for us.
Cool.
We're gonna put them on our arm.
Okay, yeah.
And see if we can, like, and it'll stretch.
You know what, when I did it, I have very pointy nails.
Oh, we'll see, okay.
So,
good to know.
If it breaks,
oh, it's
not because my arm's too big. It's because
your nails are pointy. Okay,
yeah.
I'll wait for you. This is like a condom contest.
Okay, here we go.
My mom's gonna be so proud. Okay, ready?
What should we do?
I unrolled it. Damn it.
Okay.
Okay.
You did.
Ready?
Sure. No.
You're like a lot.
Yeah,
it's gonna look gross with my arm hair.
You go.
I wonder how far I can get it back.
Probably
pretty far.
Pretty far.
Oh, it's okay though. The part that matters is still whole. Okay.
I can't break it with my nails.
You got this. Maybe you shouldn't, like, there you go.
Here we go.
If you're listening, you should probably just watch on YouTube. It'll make
my nail broke it.
Oh, your nail broke it. Okay, but the part that matters.
Yeah, it's
point proven, right?
It.
Yeah,
you
we
have
got
it.
Just the.
And you saw
just
the photo.
The edge. Yeah.
It definitely. It won't break.
Yeah.
If you
but
don't
I
have
feel like
super
that's a good message
nails.
To send kids. Wear a condom.
I mean, yeah. It was a fun thing. And it was, like, I did it because I thought it would be fun. But at the same time, it's like, it has
a
message.
A message.
And it
people
was,
don't really...
and it, people think that I did it because I wanted to, like, I don't know, be mean to guys.
Yeah.
But it's like, it's not a punishment for
safe
guys.
Safe sex. Yeah, it's good for everyone.
Yeah.
Because people don't really, in the U.S., talk about sex as much. It's a lot more
so
open
weird.
In Sweden. I know, it is weird. The gays, we talk about it, but nobody else does. But
yeah, I know. And some people, of course, people want to talk about it in the interviews I've been to.
Yeah.
And they're like, so, you know, the thing you did with, you know, the...
the condom thing.
Oh, you said the condom word!
It's funny. People are kind
really
of prude,
like
right?
That. It's really like that, and it's so weird, but yeah.
This is how you prevent pregnancy, people.
Yeah.
Okay, on that note, we gotta go out with a bang, right? Okay, tell us what's coming up for you in the rest of the year.
I'm releasing, so I just dropped my EP. I'm releasing a full-length album in May, is the plan.
Okay.
And after that, I'll be, like I said, hopefully doing a radio tour or touring for or with someone else. And then we'll see.
Exciting. And go ahead and plug your website and your socials.
Yeah.
What's your website?
I was like...
You're like, one.
Yeah. I'm basically Zara Larsson everywhere.
Everywhere. Perfect.
Yeah.
And we'll post all your stuff, too. Thank you so much for coming in here
today. Thank you so
much
for having me.
The EP is great.
Thank you.
If you guys want more from AfterBuzz, subscribe to our YouTube channel. Follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, at AfterBuzzTV. And make sure you comment with hashtag Spotlight On, and we will reply to everything. I'm Jason Ikeler, and this has been Spotlight On Zara.
Yay!
From executive producers Maria Menounos, Kevin Undergaro, Phil Svitek, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV network. To watch or listen to other after shows and post comments or questions, be sure to visit AfterBuzzTV.com. I'm Sir Richard Wentworth, and this has been a presentation of AfterBuzz TV.
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principals.